谢谢。
Thank you。
你好。
大家好。
Oh, sorry.
Welcome.
真的。It's good to be here.
我很荣幸的，很快乐的来到你当中。
And good to hear the testimony, thanks to Benji's translation.
谢谢 Ben 的翻译，我能够听到 Harry 的见证。
It's always good to hear the influence of family and the church on someone's life.
总是能够听到家庭和教会对人们生命的影响。
Yeah, very special.
非常特别。
Last Sunday night, we had two more baptisms.
过去的上一周我们有两个受洗。
And the young people said how much they found here in the church, how much they were loved and accepted.
两个年轻人说他们很融入这个教会，然后很享受在这边的时光。
And they found the truth of the word for their lives.
他们也找到他们生命当中的真理。
So we're very excited.
我们非常的兴奋。
All right, I'm going to pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray. Father God, as we look at your word now, we pray that you will open our hearts to hear it into our lives.
神的，今天我们祈求，当我们在看你的话语的时候，求你的真理，你的圣灵就进入到我们当中。
You've given us a wonderful passage to read.
你给我们这样一个美好的一篇经文给我们读。
It contains these prophetic words from you to us.
包括了这奇妙的言语。
Benji and I are your servants.
Ben 和我是你的仆人。
We want to be used by you now.
我们想要被你使用。
May we speak clearly and with love and grace and truth.
求我们的口人能够讲明白你的道理，能够讲清你的真理。
May we all hear you speak to us.
让我们都能够听到你的声音。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Amen. Good. Well, in the morning services, we've been working our way through the book of Isaiah.
在过去一段时间，早上的英文聚会当中，我们一步步学习了赛亚书。
This is a book that was written 700 years before Jesus was born.
这本书是早在耶稣出生前700年所写的。
And yet in this book we have incredible detail about Jesus.
然而他对耶稣基督的预表具体到让人难以置信的地步。
Firstly, God speaks to his people through the prophet Isaiah about their sin of adultery.
首先神通过先知以赛亚告诉他的子民犯了拜偶像的罪。
They were following other gods.
他们跟随其他的神。
They were seeking other things ahead of God.
他把其他的事物摆在了神的前面。
So then God tells them because of their sin, he's going to send them into exile in Babylon.
神又告诉以色列人，神将会把他们流放到巴比伦，是因为他们所犯的罪。
And then he said he will send a ruler of another nation to rescue them and set them free.
然后神还会使用另外一个国家的统治者来拯救他们，使以色列人重新得自由。
It was incredible as this person did not know God.
而更奇妙的是，这个拯救者并不认识神。
And it all happened just as God prophesied.
这就像神所预言的发生了。
He said his name would be Cyrus, and he was the Persian ruler.
他说这个人的名字是居鲁士，又称塞鲁。善鲁士，然后他是波斯国的创造者。
And all this was before Cyrus was even born or anybody knew his name.
神在预言这一切的时候是在居鲁士出生很早以前。
Yet the problem of sin in their hearts and lives remained.
但是只要罪还充斥在以色列的心中和生命中
，They could still not live lives that were faithful to God.
他们还是没有办法活出一个虔诚的生活。
And God, so God reveals how a servant will come.
接下来，神启示了一个仆人的降临。
A suffering servant who will come and pay with his life for their sin.
是一个受苦难的仆人，为我们罪而是一个受苦难的仆人，为了赎我们的罪，付出了自己的性命。
But also how he would be a light to the nations. People would see God through him.
神又启示他将成为世界的光， 成就了神所拣选子民没有完成的使命。
Fulfilling all that God's people failed to be.
成就了神所拣选的子民所没有完成的使命。
And we haven't got time, but there's some cool passages where Jesus himself is speaking through Isaiah 700 years before he was born. So there's some cool passages where you actually have Jesus speaking to us before he was born.
在有些章节里我们其实可以看到耶稣基督是借着以赛亚来告诉我们这些事情是发生在耶稣诞生以前的。就是
That sounds good. Chapter 53 though is extraordinary.
第五三章便是最不可思议的启示。
Because in chapter 53 we have specific detail of God sending his son to die for us.
这里启示了神告诉世人他将会派他的独生爱子为我们而死。
I'll read just a few pieces of it. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities, the punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed.
第五三章第五节，哪知他为我们的过犯受害，为我们的罪孽压伤，因他受的刑罚我们得平安，因他受的鞭伤我们得医治。
We all like sheep have gone astray, each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
第六节，我们都如羊走迷，个人偏行己路，耶和华使我们众人的罪孽都归在他身上。
For he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgression.
第十二节，他却担当众人的罪，又为罪代求。
I encourage you to read that passage. It's 52 and 53. Graphic, specific detail about Jesus dying on the cross for us. 700 years before it happened.
我们应该更多的去读第五十二章到五十三章，这里讲述的故事都是在发生这些事情七百年以前所记载。
And then in chapter 54, God tells of the promises He can now make us because of all that He would achieve in Jesus.
第五十四节所记载神的应许，因着耶稣基督，这一切都被成就。
Promises of everlasting kindness and love toward us.Promises of His compassion toward us.
这些应许包括神对我们很久不变的温柔和慈爱，也都因着他的怜悯。
Now here in chapter 55, we have this most wonderful expression of God's love.
在第五十五章，我们看到对神的爱最好的描述。
This is God's chapter. This is God's invitation to come and to receive.All that God has achieved for us in Jesus.
这段经节代表了神对我们的邀请，好叫我们来到他的面前，领受在基督里他为我们所成就的事。
To its original readers, it wouldn't have meant as much as it does to us, because we've seen so much now fulfilled.
相对于我们认识耶稣基督的人来说，那时候读者没有办法像我们。这样清楚的去认识到这样的一件故事，是因为我们有看到神的耶稣基督的作为。
So God says to us, "Come, buy and eat."
神说：“你们都来买了吃。
”God invites us to come.
在第一节中，神邀请我们来。
Four times in verse 1 he says, "Come."
在这里，他四次提到来。
His invitation is expressed in the strongest of terms.
神用最迫切的方式来表达他对我们的邀请。
God is saying, we must come.
神说我们必须得接受这样的邀请。
Firstly, it's an invitation to all who are thirsty.
第一，这一个邀请是给所有饥渴慕义的人。
To all who know their great need.
给那些知道自己有真正需求的人。
Who know they're not satisfied.
给那些得不到满足的人。
I heard that in your testimony.
我有听到从 Harry 的证道里面，他有提到满足。
It's an invitation to come and to receive without Christ. You who are without money.
来承受这份邀请是不需要付上任何代价。
It's an invitation to come and to receive God's gift of life. They're right at the bottom of page 53.
Yeah. 来承受这份邀请是不需要付上代价。
And then to number two, is that right?
Okay. 这份邀请是给那些付不起代价。这一份邀请来承受神所馈赠的新生命，它是免费馈赠。
Just as well I can read Mandarin, isn't it? Okay, number two. It's an invitation to those who do not know they are thirsty.
这份邀请也是给那些不知道自己有真正的有渴望的人。
God says, why spend money on what is not bread, and your labor on what does not satisfy?
你们为何要花钱买那些不足为食物的，用劳碌得来的买那不使人饱足的呢？
The person who has material resources and money, but still does not have what they are really needing.
有些人有丰富的物质和金钱，却还不知道他们真正的需要。
They've got the ability to chase after and pay for all manner of things, yet they are not satisfied.
他们有能力、财力去追求各式各样的事物，但是还是无法从中得到满足。
Satisfaction cannot be bought with money.
金钱买不到这种满足。
The world is shopping and craving for satisfaction.
整个世界都在追求和渴望得到这种满足。
Even selling their lives for that which does not satisfy.
甚至卖掉我们，卖掉他们的性命，也换不来这种满足。
So God invites the materially poor and the rich to come and receive His gift.
所以无论你是物质贫乏还是富足，神都邀请你来接受他的礼物。
And the gift that God invites us to come and receive is good.
神邀请我们来接受的礼物是美好。
Listen to me. And eat what is good. And you will delight in the richest of fare. Give ear and come to me. Listen.That you may live, I will make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love, promise to David.
第五十五章第二节，你们要留意听我的话，就能吃那美物，得享甘肥甘，心中喜乐，你们当就近我来，侧耳而听，就必得活。我必与你们立永约，就应许大卫那。
In Luke chapter 14, Jesus tells the story of a banquet where he invites people to come to the banquet.
在路加福音十四章，耶稣形容这份礼物就像是一场丰盛的盛宴，然后他邀请大家来参加这个盛宴。
But in that invitation, some say, "Oh, I'm married, or I bought a field, or I bought a cow. I would rather go and do those things."
在那段经节当中，有些人找借口说：“我买了一块地，我要去结婚，我买了牛，所以说我没有办法来参加聚会。”
And then at the end of the Bible, right at the end, Jesus says, "I'm coming soon."
在圣经的最后一篇，启示录里，他讲的是我马上就要到。
And we read, "The Spirit and the Bride say, 'Come.'" Let the one who hears say, come. Let the one who is thirsty come. Let the one who wishes to take the free gift of the water of life come.
圣灵和心腹说，来，听见的人也该说，来，口渴的人也当来，愿意的都白白取生命的水喝。
And so God pleads with us to come and receive his free gift of eternal life.
神恳请我们能够来到他面前来领取这一份礼物。
He says, "Come buy eat." How do we buy?
神说来到他面前不用银钱，不用价值，一起享受。
We come by valuing his invitation.
我们要怎样去买呢？我们聚在一起是因为我们重视他的邀请，我们相信和信靠。
By believing and trusting, it's worth receiving.
我们相信和信靠这份礼物是值得拥有。
Now Benji says to me, "Come, I'm going to give you my car."
Ben 没有说我来，我要把我的车给 Peter。
I would be silly if I said no.
我会觉得我很愚蠢如果我不接受这样的邀请。
He's got a good car.
我没有好车。
Well, it's not bad.
其实也不错。
God offers us forgiveness of sins. God offers us new life. God offers us eternal life. We would be nuts to say no.
神给了我们原谅，给了我们新生命，我们会，如果我们不接受神的礼物的话，我们其实是，笨蛋。
Seek the Lord, he says, while he may be found. Call on him while he is near.
当趁耶和华可寻找的时候，寻找他，相近的时候求告他。
It's a free gift.
这里不是免费的。
So we must respond when we hear it.
所以我们必须要回应当我们听到这样的信息。
As a pastor, how many times I've heard of God speak to people and they say, I'm going to do it, and then they never do.
做牧师的时候我也看到你们当中有多少人听到神的话决心要回应他却到最后从来没有做到。
God invites us to seek and to apply His truths and His blessings and His promises into our lives.
他邀请我们去寻求真理、祝福还有应许，并且把这些都运用在我们的生活当中。
Some of you have sensed God say, "I love you."
大家有听到说神爱，神爱我。
But you have to believe it.
但你必须得相信。
It's no good if you won't believe it.
如果你不相信的话，就没有任何益处。
We have to receive it into our lives. God loves me.
我们必须从心里去接受神是爱我们的。
God's invitation is to a life and to a satisfaction that is not ours by anything that we can do by our own strength and will.
凭借我们自身的能力以及意愿，我们是没有办法。做到和得到神所应许的新生命和满足。
He invites us to let go of that which harms us so that we can receive all that is good.
他邀请我们放下那些伤害我们的，好叫我们可以领受那一切美好。
So he says, let the wicked forsake their ways and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord and he will have mercy on them and to our God.For he will freely pardon.
第七节，恶人当离弃自己的道路，不义的人当除掉自己的意念，归向耶和华，耶和华就必怜悯他。当归向我们的神，因为神必广行赦免。
So it begins with repentance, which opens the way for God's mercy and His forgiveness to flood into our lives.
一切始于悔改，悔改可以使神的慈爱和原谅像源源不断的江河进入到我们生命当中。
And God will freely pardon us.
神必广行赦免。
So simply, God invites us to buy by forsaking or giving away all the bad parts of our life so that He can give us His good.
简单来说，神就是让我们去放弃我们，放弃我们的罪和老我，去换取他所应许的新生命。
It's exchanging our weaknesses and our sinful behaviors for God's good life.
就像我们用我们的罪恶的罪性去换神所应许的美好。
And then number three, then we eat.
第三点，然后我们来吃。
This is a mystery.
这是一个谜。
It's beyond our understanding.
这超出了我们的自然的推理和经验。
God says, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways." My ways.
第八节神说我的意念非同你们的意念我的道路非同你们的道路。
God works something into our lives that is beyond our understanding.
神在我们生命中所做的工远远超过我们想象和理解的。
The Bible says that we are strong when we're weak.
神说当我们软弱的时候我们就刚强。
We're exalted when we're humble.
我们谦卑的话我们就得尊荣。
We're free when we're a slave.
我们得自由的时候我们就去服侍神。
And we live by dying.
我们也因此得复活。
Doesn't make sense.
一点都说不通。
But God says, as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
但第九节，神说，天怎样高过地，照样我的道路高过你的道路，我的意念超过你的意念。
But then he explains how he works these changes in our lives. God says, my word that goes out from my mouth, it will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it.
神接着说，我口所出的话也必如此，绝不突然返回，却要成就我所喜悦的，在我发他去成就的事上必然亨通。
God's word works in our hearts and changes us.
神的话语在我们的心中动工来改变我们。
We don't fully understand all that God did by sending Jesus to die on the cross.
我们并不能完全理解神的作为，他让耶稣基督为我们的罪死在十字架上。
Yet we believe he did it for our good.
我们相信他这样做是为我们好。
And he invites us to receive it from him.
他邀请我们去从他那边接受这样的礼物。
To come and to take it.
让我们来到他面前去领受。
How does it all work?
这样到底是怎么一回事呢？
I don't know.
我也不知道。
But I do know his word is true.
但我知道是他的话是真实的。
And his word is powerful.
有能力。
And his word can create in us the most wonderful things.
他的话语能创造不可思议的事情。
God says his word is like rain and snow on dry ground.
神说他的话语就像雨水和雪花一样洒在干燥的地上。
It waters and creates life in abundance.
它浇灌生命，创造丰富。
I love watching the snow.
我喜欢看下雪。
As it drops down out of the air.
慢慢从天空中掉下来。
Yeah, that's it. And the light rain that comes down on the ground.
绵绵的细雨从天上掉下来。
And as the rain waters the ground, the plants grow.
雨水湿润了大地。然后生命就从土里长出。
How does that happen?
这是怎样一回事呢？
I'm a scientist.
我是一名科学家。
But there's still mysteries there. It's amazing what God does.
但是还是有很多谜，然后神的作为是很。
And His word is like water on our lives, and good things grow when we allow that water, that word, into our lives.
他的话语就像水一样来浇灌我们的生命，然后从我们的生命当中可以活出一个新。
And God says that you may live. I will make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love, promised to David.
侧耳而听，就必得活。你们我必与你们立永约，就是应许大卫那可靠的恩典。
Just as God's words were powerful at creation, creating mountains and sea and forests and birds and wonderful people like this.
神的话语是有能力的，他的话语创造生命，创造每一个我们。
And then God sent Jesus, and he was called the Word. And the Word became flesh, and through Jesus, God creates new life in us.
他派遣耶稣基督，他的独生子，就是那一位在约翰福音里提到的道成肉身，在我们心中创建了不可思议的生命。
So why wouldn't you want to receive that?
所以说我们为什么不去接受这样一份礼物呢？
God says to us, come.
神说，来吧。
Come, all you who are thirsty, come to the waters, and you who have no money, come.Eat, buy and eat.
你们一切干渴的都当进就进来，就进水来。没有银钱的也可以来。我们都来，你们都来，买了吃。
and you will go out in joy and be led forth in peace.
你们必欢欢喜喜而出来，平平安安得蒙引导。
Today he invites you through Pastor Jack to come and to receive the bread and the cup.
今天我们会在蒋牧师的带领下去领受主的杯和主的餐。
Simple symbols which represent the incredible realities of new life.
这一简单的标志代表不可思议的现实。
Today God invites you to come.To buy, to eat.
就在今天，神邀请我们每个人来到他面前去领受，去他的里面。
God bless.
神，愿神祝福。
谢谢。
Thank you.